अस्सलाम वालेकुम। बिफोर द एग्ज़ाम वी स्टार्टेड विद द टॉपिक ऑफ ट्रैफिक सेफ्टी एंड वी लुक्ड एट द प्रोसेस ऑफ डूइंग डूइंग व्हाट या रोड सेफ्टी ऑडिट्स या सो वी लुक्ड एट द प्रोसेस ऑफ रोड सेफ्टी ऑडिट्स. The next thing which we will look at is the conflict analysis. Okay, so first of all we start with the definition of what is a conflict. So this definition is provided by Manual of Transportation Engineering Studies. Okay, so it's a manual which gives the details about how to conduct transportation related studies. So according to them, any potentially risky interaction between two or more vehicles or road users when the vehicle has to take an evasive the vehicle or the road user has to take an evasive action. Evasive means when an action which you take to avoid something. Okay, an action which you take to avoid something, that is an evasive action. Okay, so for example, a vehicle braking or weaving to avoid a collision is a conflict. Okay, it's an evasive action. So whenever an evasive action is taken, that is a conflict. Okay, so conflicts are used as surrogate measures. Surrogate meaning representative, surrogate meaning an alternative representative. Okay, so we use conflict studies or conflicts as alternate representative of the crashes or accidents. Why? Because accidents happen very randomly and very rarely. Okay, so it may happen that for some sites or some locations the number of accidents may not be available, because let's say the site is newly constructed. We have just constructed the site, we have just constructed that highway, so obviously the number of accidents are not available. Okay, but conflicts happen on daily basis. Okay, you can go and see on a site how and which type of conflicts are happening. Okay, so a conflict study does not require even much resources as well. Okay, even one or two person can do a conflict study for a site. Okay, so we don't require many resources. A person will go to the site with a pen and paper and he will record the conflicts manually. Okay, obviously conflicts have to be recorded manually. Okay, although let me show you some videos, couple of videos. First of all, this is a video where it is showing. See this. These are conflicts. This one. See this one. So this conflict, which actually resulted in this driver had. He has just left off, huh? He doesn't mind getting bumped into the car, huh? Anyways, so if this driver had taken an evasive action, this would have been a conflict, only a conflict, but obviously it resulted in a crash. Okay, let me show you another video where they are showing a video tool. Okay, a camera tool which can identify the conflicts. See closely here, see some of these are conflicts. Okay. Some of them are also conflicts. Okay, so here they were showing a video tool, a camera tool, which can identify the conflicts from the video. But most of the times it is done manually because you cannot rely on the camera or the tool to identify all the conflicts. But anyways, the tool is there if you want to use it. Going back to the point, so I was saying conflict is a representative alternative of accidents, because accidents, most of the times you avoid the accidents. Most of the times you avoid the crash because the driver was careful, or the other driver was careful, or the road was road has some margin of safety or something like this. So if you just go by the number of crashes, they will be very small. If you look at number of crashes for any site, they will be very small. But if you do a conflict study at that site, you will see the real problem at the location. Okay, because conflicts happen on, like I have shown you in the video, every time the signal turns green, the conflicts are happening. Every time you enter an intersection, the conflicts are happening. Every time a pedestrian wants to cross, conflicts are happening. The conflicts happen more frequently as compared to crashes. So they are easy to observe, easy to identify, and easy to collect the data for. Okay. So they can be used very easily in the absence of any accident data. So what is a conflict? Whenever a road user has to take an evasive action. Okay. Somebody did something to avoid a crash. Okay. To avoid the collision, and that is a conflict. Okay. Whether it is braking, whether it is changing the lane, weaving from its direction or something like this, this is a conflict. Okay. Okay. So where can we use conflict analysis? We can use in the conflict analysis, we are trying to find out the number of and type of conflicts which happen at an intersection. Okay. So it is mainly related or mainly used for intersection. You can use it for segments as well, but the main use is for the intersection, like I showed you in the previous videos as well. So doing a conflict analysis, you can know the extent of a safety problem at a location. Okay, so you have a safety problem at a location. So how big is it? Okay, if it is causing too many conflicts, that means a major problem, right? It makes sense. If it is causing too many, because like accidents, conflicts can also happen because of driver behavior as well. So if they are randomly conflicts happening in a small amount, that is not a problem. But if conflicts keep on happening, like I showed you in the previous video, after every few seconds you are having a conflict, that is a problem, right? That is a bigger problem. Or you can also use conflict analysis to find out the effectiveness of any countermeasure. So at a particular site, you identified the problem and you applied a countermeasure to eradicate that problem, to solve that problem. But that countermeasure, whether it is working or not, you go there and apply the conflict analysis. Okay. Again, if you wait for the accidents to happen, then it may be too wrong, too late, right? It may be too late. You applied a countermeasure and now you are staying back and you are relaxing that, okay, let's see whether accidents happen or not. Accidents may happen. Somebody may lose his or her life. Okay. They will have property damages. They will have injuries. Okay. So it is a better approach to do the conflict analysis and see whether the countermeasure is reducing the conflicts or not. Okay. So these are the known conflict types which have been identified for intersections. Okay. So some of them can be applied to, you can apply them to segments as well. Okay, you do segments as well, but normally this is not the case. Okay, for a particular intersection, for a particular location, you may select some of these types to be observed. Okay, because if you are observing all types of conflicts, then obviously you will need more time, you will need more people. Okay, and there are more chances of making an error in your observation. So you may select few important conflict types that if these type of conflicts happen, then I will record. Okay, and how do you select the type of conflicts? That will be on the basis of some preliminary data or some prior observation. So you already did some pilot study at an intersection, and you know, okay, these type of conflicts are more happening more frequently. So out of all of them, I will only observe these type. Okay, or somebody already reported that we are having these type of crashes. So you know, these type of crashes are because of these type of conflicts. So I will observe these ones. Okay, let me make it bigger. Okay, so these conflict types are basically the same as a crash type as well. Okay, so for example, left turning in the same direction. Okay, so two vehicles are turning left in the same direction. Similarly, two vehicles are turning right in the same direction. So because of the vehicle in front, somebody may have to, this vehicle at the back may have to brake. He may have to change the lane or something. That will be a conflict. Okay. Then slow moving vehicle in the same direction. Okay, two vehicles going in the same direction straight. Okay, lane changing, conflict because of lane changing. Conflict because of a left turning from the opposite direction. Conflict because of the left turning from the cross traffic. Okay, not the left turning, right turning. Right turning from the cross traffic. Okay, conflict, left turning from the cross traffic. Okay. Then through cross traffic, okay, coming from the right, and then this is so right turning, okay, somebody taking a right turning, okay, from cross traffic, and then this one left turning cross traffic. Okay, then this is through traffic coming from the left. Okay, then this is two opposing this guy is taking the right left turn, and this guy is taking the right turn from here. Okay, the opposing right turn on red. Okay, so you are taking the left turn because it's green for you, and this guy is taking the right turn because he's taking the right turn. Okay, so he can take. Then we have pedestrian. Okay, pedestrian far side, which is the other side of the intersection, and pedestrian near side, okay, which is at your side of the intersection. Okay, so these are the types of conflicts which they have defined for an intersection. Okay, you can use conflict analysis to compare between different alternatives. Okay, so you are trying to see what type of design alternative I can apply to my site. So what you can do is you can go to sites at which those particular options are already applied. For example, you are considering putting a left turn lane. Okay, an extra left turn lane. So you can go to the sites which have extra left-hand lane, and you can observe the conflicts on their sides, and you can know whether it will solve the problem on your side or not. Okay, again, if you are looking for accident data, then you will have only few sites to compare, but conflict analysis can be done for any site with a extra left-hand lane. Okay, so you can do it. So you are considering different options, go to the sites which have these options, and you do the conflict analysis and see whether it is reducing the conflicts which you want to reduce or not. Okay. Or you can also do conflict studies as a preliminary study, okay, a pilot study, a preliminary study before you conduct detailed site investigations. Okay, so you are looking at for which site I should do the detailed analysis. Okay, later on we will see what do we mean by detailed analysis, but it will involve more effort. It will you will collect more data for those sites. So which sites should be selected for doing detailed investigations? You will do a preliminary conflict studies for them, for all the sites which you have. Like I said, it doesn't require much time or resources, so it's easier to do. So on the basis of this easier study, then you go for a more detailed study. So the previous conflict types which I showed you, they can be divided into three main types. Okay, so all the previous, I think there were how many? 1, 2, 3. And 1, 2, 3, 4, so 12 plus 2, 14. Okay, so we have total 14 types of conflicts, and these 14 conflicts can be divided to three main types. These are diverging, merging, and crossing. Diverging, merging, and crossing. Okay. So diverging is, these two are diverging. Okay. So you have one guy who wants to go straight, and you have another guy who wants to take a left turn. Okay. So this is diverging, and this is also diverging. Okay. I'm just showing some examples of each type. Okay. I'm just showing some examples of each type. So you see, I did not mention all the 14 conflict types here. Okay, so there may be other diverging conflicts as well, but I'm just trying to explain the point here. Okay, so whenever two drivers who are coming from the same direction and one of them decides to go in a different direction, that is a diverging conflict point. Okay, so diverging are normally less problematic. Okay, less problematic in the sense that they are easier to handle, and they are less likely to result, like the accidents which can happen because of them are less likely. Okay, the chances of them resulting in an accident are less likely. Okay, and they often happen because of their driver confusion. For example, a driver on a roundabout decides to exit the roundabout, but then he rethinks and he decides that, oh no, I don't want to get out from this approach, this was a wrong approach, let me try to get back into the roundabout itself. Okay, so this is the example of a driver confusion. Okay, so obviously he will be, for example, let me make it here. So he was going on the roundabout like this, and he decided, no, I want to get out of this lane, and then he decided, no, this is a wrong approach and I should get back into my lane. So this will cause a diverging conflict point. Okay, so you can see that this is because of a driver confusion. Okay, so a driver was confused whether I should take the turn or not. So this can happen in a diverging conflict point or a accident because of that. Although the possibility of having an accident because of diverging is less, but these accidents can be extremely dangerous whenever they happen. Merging conflict points are more prominent. They happen more frequently. Okay, and they can result in sideswipe. Okay, so what is a sideswipe? Somebody damaging your car from the side. Okay, so you know that it is, it is of low severity. This type of conflict will result in a low severity accident. Again, I am talking about the conflict. Okay, so the actual accident may or may not have happened. If it happens, then it may result in a sideswipe accident. This is what we are saying. Okay, we are not saying the conflict will happen in a sideswipe. Okay, conflict is somebody saved the accident. Okay, but it was a conflict. Somebody slowed down, somebody changed its lane. So the accident, the crash did not happen. That is a conflict. Okay, if the crash happened, two vehicles collided into each other, that is an accident. Okay, that means the accident already happened. Okay, so merging are related to poor understanding of the driver. The driver did not understand in which lane he should be or when he should be crossing and so on. It can be because of poor design. There was not enough side distance, or there was lack of signage or markings on the site. Okay, so this can result in merging conflicts. Crossing conflicts are extremely problematic. Okay, two vehicles passing each other, you can see here. So they can result in angle or left turning opposing collisions. Okay, these conflicts can happen in angle or left turning opposing collisions. So two vehicles coming from opposing directions and they are bumping into each other or crossing each other at right angle. Okay, or it can happen because of left turning as well. You can see it here. It can happen because of left turning. So these accidents are more the most dangerous ones. The most dangerous ones, and if these type of conflicts happen, if crossing conflicts are happening, that means the likelihood of accident is more is higher. Okay, possibility of having an accident because of crossing conflicts is higher as compared to other conflicts. Okay, let us do some examples. Okay, how to identify the conflicts at a particular location and how you can compare between different types of designs on like on paper. Okay. So for example, you can see here, this is a four leg intersection, okay, and this is a roundabout, okay, and they are trying to compare the number of conflicts point between them, okay. Now, so on a, how do you do that? Whenever you are comparing between different sides on a paper, what do you do? The procedure is, first of all, draw all the possible movements. Draw all the possible movements, okay. And then wherever these movements are either merging or diverging or crossing, you mark the conflict points. Okay, so you can see here they have marked this. So this movement is possible, this right turning is possible, this left turning is possible, then this movement, okay, again right turning, left turning, okay, and then for the east west direction as well. Okay, so for each approach of the intersection, mark all the movements which are possible. Okay, then you can see, for example, this one, if you take this approach, so when he, this guy is taking the left right turn and another guy wants to go straight, this is a merging, or sorry, this is a diverging conflict point. Okay, similarly, when there can be a driver who is going straight and then the other driver who is taking a left turn, okay, so one driver going straight from the same approach, another driver taking a left turn from the same approach, what type of conflict point is it? Can you tell me what type of conflict point is it? This one, one guy going straight, the other guy going taking a left turn from the same side, what type of conflict point is it?
Diverging.
Okay, similarly, this guy is going straight and this guy is coming straight from this direction, eastbound. So one guy going straight, northbound, another guy going straight, eastbound. What type of conflict point is it? This one?
Crossing.
Yes, crossing. Okay. Then this guy who is taking a taking a left turn, northbound, right turn. So he has come from here. He has taken a right turn. And then this guy is coming straight from here, eastbound. Okay, so what type of conflict point is this one?
Merging.
Okay, so obviously this looks very congested, so you have to look at each movement and you have to see, but once you have the idea, then it will be same for each approach, right? So once I can find out how many conflict points I have for, let's say, a northbound approach, they will be the same for southbound, same for the eastbound, same for the westbound as well. Okay, so this is a repetitive exercise. Okay, so even if you know the conflict points for one side, then it is the same for every other side as well, unless you make a change in the geometry of the route. Okay, so for a four-leg intersection, they have done it. So you can look at this whole picture in your own time and you can see they have marked the conflict points using different symbols, okay, and the symbology is given here, so you can try to understand the conflict is happening between which vehicles. Okay, my suggestion will be that you should do that to understand the idea behind it. Anyways, so each approach of a four-leg intersection can have two diverging conflicts, two merging conflicts, and then four crossing conflicts. Each approach can have two diverging, two merging, and four crossing conflicts. So in total, the four approaches will have 8 diverging, 8 merging, and 16 crossing conflicts. Okay, how it is already shown here, and like I said, you can draw a four-leg intersection yourself and repeat this whole exercise. Okay, see how many you can identify and then you can cross check your answer from here. Okay, so anyways, on a four leg intersection, we have 32 conflict points. Okay, we have 32 conflict points on a four leg intersection. A roundabout, you see, much cleaner, much clearer. Okay, so we have the roundabout. Okay, so again, you do the same thing. You mark all the movements. So one movement is this circular movement, right? on roundabout, one movement is the circular movement. Then from each approach, you will have the entry to the roundabout, and for each approach, you will have the exit. Okay, so one conflict point when you are entering, and the other one when you are exiting. So the entry one, the conflict point at the entry, which type of conflict is it? When you are entering the roundabout, what type of conflict is
merging.
It? Merging. And when you are exiting?
Diverging.
Diverging. Okay. Do we have any crossing conflict points here?
No.
No. For which case can I have a crossing conflict point? Can some? It is not identified here. For which case, why don't we have a crossing conflict point? That is also written on the slide. If you pay attention, on a roundabout, I'm talking about the roundabout. Okay. So in which case on a roundabout, I may have a crossing conflict point? Can you tell me?
When it's not vehicle to vehicle.
Yeah, vehicle to pedestrian can be crossing, right? Vehicle to pedestrian can be crossing. Yeah. So if I mark the pedestrian movements here, then I may see crossing conflict points as well. But anyways, these crossing conflict points will also occur at the four-leg intersection as well. Then obviously then this will not remain 32 as well, right? This will increase. Anyways, for vehicle to vehicle conflicts on a roundabout, we have four diverging, four merging, no crossing, so only 8 conflict points. So putting a roundabout, you can see now, I can easily compare what is more safe, what is safer, a four-leg intersection or a roundabout. Obviously, roundabout is safer, it has less conflict points. Okay, let us look at a couple of examples. Okay, the solution to the example is already mentioned in the slide, but I will try to again explain you the procedure. Okay, so we have a U-turn median given near the intersection. This is a U-turn median. Okay, so anybody who wants to take a left turn, he cannot do it directly from the intersection. So the left turning from the intersections are blocked. He has to go take a right turn and then take a U-turn from here to take the left turn. Okay, so if I'm coming from here, I want to take a left turn in this direction, I will go in this manner. Okay, and same thing for the other sides as well. So all left turns at the main intersection are blocked, all blocked. Okay, anybody wants to take a left turn, he has to go through this U-turn median. Okay, so compared to the four-leg intersection, so for the four-leg intersection, we already know the conflict points. We have to identify the number of conflict points for this intersection with U-turn median, and then we'll compare the four-leg intersection. Okay, so again, the idea is mark all the movements. Okay, mark all the movements. So this is one movement, this is another movement. Okay, then this is another movement. Okay, then this guy may go in straight. Okay, and yeah, so this one, and then we can have same thing for the east-west as well. So we can have this movement. We can have this movement. Okay, then we can have this movement. Okay, same thing. Yeah, I did not mark this one, right? So this movement, and this one as well, and then we have that this guy can go straight as well, right? This guy can go straight as well. Anyways, so this is one conflict point. So I marked all the movements. This is one conflict point, which is crossing, another crossing, another crossing, another crossing. Okay, this is merging. This is diverging. This is also merging, right? This is diverging. This is merging. Okay, and again, this one. So this is diverging. This one merging. This one diverging. Okay. This one merging. Here diverging. Okay. And similarly, I did not mark the U-turn here. Okay. So this is again merging. Okay. So if you mark the movements properly, your work is done. If you mark the movements properly, your work is done. And my suggestion is, when you are marking the movement, whenever a conflict point comes, like, don't wait for all the movements to be marked. Don't wait for all the movements. You have already marked, let's say, only north-south movements. So whatever conflict points you can identify in the north-south movement, mark them. Okay. And like I have showed you in the previous slide, mark them with different symbols. Merging different symbol, diverging different symbol, crossing different symbol as well. Okay. It will make your life easy. So you can see they have done, and they have used different colors and different symbols. Okay, so this looks much clearer and much a neat picture and easier to understand. So, okay, so we already know 4 leg intersection, 8 diverging, 8 merging, 16 crossing. For this one, we have 6 diverging, 6 merging, and 4 crossing only. Okay, so crossing is only these ones, right? These are only crossings. Okay. So from 16 reduced to 4. So these are the main conflict points which we have reduced, the crossing conflict points. Okay. Others, diverging change from 8 to 6, merging change from 8 to 6. Okay. So there's a change, but not so much. Okay. So but in the end, you have halved the number of conflict points by providing a median U-turn. Okay. Then this is for a pedestrian movement. So the pedestrian movement is only allowed for this street. So what conflict points we can have? Okay. So again, you mark the movements which are crossing. They, in this example, they have done it for all the movements, but I will only do it for the movement which are crossing. Okay. You can see the complete sketch in the next slide. Okay. So from this, I have vehicle going in this direction, taking a right turn, then a vehicle going in this direction, taking a left turn, and then a vehicle coming from this direction, a vehicle coming from this direction. Okay, so basically both of them are coming in the same direction, right? Both of them are coming in the same direction. This is one conflict point. Okay, this is another conflict point. This is another conflict point, and this is another conflict point. Okay, so we have four conflict points. Okay, one because of the two at the exit line and two at the entry line. Okay, now in the book, if you go to the book, they are saying this one should be considered as one. Okay, these two should be considered as one, but I don't know why. Okay, if this is two, then this should also be two, right? Makes sense. See here. So if this is two conflict points, then this should also be two conflict points, vehicles coming from different direction. Anyways, I will check. Okay, I will check, try to check from some other book. Okay, come back to you. Just remind me. Okay, so like we said, if you are doing a conflict analysis in the field, it is done much faster because conflicts happen so frequently, so you don't have to wait for longer time to see so many conflicts. But accidents happen very rarely. You may have one accident in the whole week, so one accident is not enough to do any analysis, right? Field evaluation for conflict analysis can be done in 4 different ways. Okay, you can do a before and after study. We have done before and after study in traffic course as well. You can do a cross-sectional study. You can do a reference group study, and you can do a frequency method study as well. So these are 4 different methods of field evaluation using conflict analysis. Okay. So before and after study is less common because we need 2 data sets there, before data and after data. And that means whenever we are doing before and after, that means some change has happened on the site. So you need the data before the change happened, and you need the data after the change happened. Somebody may not have remembered to do the before study, right? So somebody already made the change, and now they are saying do a study, conflict study. I don't have the before data. I cannot go back in time, okay? So unless you have a time machine, the before and after study must have been planned properly. Okay, so this is why it is less common. Okay, so like I said, you have done some safety measures or operational measures on the site, and you want to know whether it is effective or not. you can do a before and after study. Okay. It is shorter as compared to other studies, so it takes less time because you already know the major you have applied and you already know the expected results of the major. So like I said, you introduced a left turning lane. So you are only looking at the conflicts of the left turning lane. And you know what type of conflict we are supposed to reduce. Okay, obviously when you made the change, you had something in mind. So you are only checking that. Okay, so to do that, you will only focus on specific types of conflicts, maybe for one or two directions only. So it takes a very small time to complete that. Okay, but like I said, you must plan it before you make the change. Then we have cross-section study. Cross-section study is done when you already missed the before time. So you already made the change. You did not have the time to do the before study. Okay, so you compare it then between the different intersections which have the same type of which are in the same state as the as this site was in the before case. Okay, so for example, introducing the extra left turning lane on your site, you did not do the before study. So do the study with the left turning lane on your site and do the study for the sites which do not have the left turning lane but are similar to your sites. Okay, so the so this is cross-sectional. So I'm comparing between two different sites. One site is the after data, the site which I'm interested in. The other site which with which I'm comparing with is in the same state as my site was before I made the change. Okay, so this is a cross-section study. Okay, so then you can see, okay, this particular type of conflict is happening on my site, and sorry, this particular conflict type is happening on that site which I'm comparing, and this is not happening on my site. So this is the conflict which is reduced because of my lane or my major. Okay, so you're comparing between different sites, but these sites are in different conditions. One of them is in the condition of the site of your site which it was before you made the change. Okay, then you have a reference group study. It is similar to cross-section study, so you are comparing between different sites. Okay, but you are comparing between so you have a group of sites, which you have a group of sites which are similar to each other. Okay, you have a group of sites which have similar to each other. Okay, so you take the data on all the sites. Okay, and you try to find out what is the average rate of conflict at each site. Okay, so then you compare whether your site is close to the average or is different from the average. Okay, so instead of comparing with one site, I am comparing with the whole group. Okay, obviously this is this type of study, a reference group study, is unlikely because of the unavailability and the unreliability of the data. Okay, you need many sites which are similar to each other, and then you may be missing a point, you may be missing a key difference between the sites. Okay, so you are saying the sites are similar, but maybe there is a important change in one of the sites which you did not take into account. Okay, so this is okay, so this is a data from Kansas City study. Okay, so they have collected data from signalized intersections. These two are signalized intersections and these are unsignalized intersections. This is the type of conflict points and the rate of conflict point for each one of them. Okay, so the mean, the variance. Okay, so for example, they have let's say signalized intersections more than 25,000 vehicles per day. Okay, so maybe they have 100 sites like this. So they have collected these conflict points for those sites. Okay, then they have calculated the mean and the variance for each site. Okay, the conflicts per hour and the conflicts per day. Okay, so you can imagine how much data they must have collected. Okay, because for each type of conflict they are calculating mean and variance, mean per hour and mean per day. Okay, and then they are calculating the 90th and the 95th percentile as well for each conflict type for all the sites. Okay, so these are the numbers for signalized intersections with more than 25,000 vehicles per day. Then this is between 10 and 25,000 vehicles per day. Then these are for unsignalized intersections and so on. Okay, so it requires a lot of data. You cannot collect data from two sites and then start comparing. Okay, it will be wrong. It will be wrong. Okay, then we have okay, so this is like the type of frequency method. Okay, so there, so see, conflicts per hour, conflicts per day, this is a frequency based method. Okay, so the difference between the group study is that in a group study, the conflicts can be on the basis of conflicts per volume and so on, okay, or number of conflict points. Here in a frequency based method, you are comparing between the rate of conflicts per hour or per day. Okay, this is the difference between the group study, the reference group study, and the frequency method. Okay, in the reference group study, you may be just comparing between the number of conflict points, but in a frequency method, you are comparing on the basis of how many conflicts are happening per hour or per day. Okay, so frequency method is similar to group study. The difference is that conflicts are calculated on the basis of their frequency, conflicts per hour or conflicts per day. Okay, so tomorrow inshallah we will continue more with the conflict studies, conflict analysis. So I'm going for the attendance. If you have any questions, you may ask.